Hi, I'm Dr Jade Murray at the Turner Institute for Brain and Mental Health and the Psychological Sciences at Monash University. I am a postdoctoral research fellow here looking at investigating the impact of circadian rhythm disturbance and misalignment on the health and well-being of a number of different populations within society, including shift workers and older adults as well. Sleep hygiene is a term that we use to refer to the good sleep habits, behaviours and environmental factors that help facilitate good and healthy sleep. So examples of good sleep hygiene include regularity of sleep timing and consistency, our bedroom environment and where we sleep, and making sure that that's not too warm, not too cold, and also making sure that we implement really good routines around sleep as well. For shift workers, obviously this can be quite difficult to manage at times, particularly that element of requiring regularity or consistency in their sleep times. And so one of the things that we need to ensure we manage with shift workers is making sure that people are implementing as many of those really good habits as they can and maintaining as much consistency to their sleep patterns when they're on more regular shift times and on their days off as well, so that they can help consolidate the timing of their sleep and make sure their body clock is in alignment with their sleep and wake times as well. Shift workers often experience an increased level of sleep deprivation or chronic sleep deprivation, which is often accumulates as a result of a misalignment between their body clock timing and the timing of their sleep and wake. This chronic sleep deprivation over time has both longer and shorter acute effects in terms of their outcomes in terms of health and well-being. On the shorter term, acute effects include an increased risk of fatigue and sleepiness while on shift or also during their commute home from shift work. And this can increase their risk of motor vehicle accidents, workplace errors, and of course injury that result from some of those errors as well. On the longer term, shift workers who experience ongoing chronic sleep deprivation and misalignment between their body clock and their sleep-wake times are at much greater risk of experiencing cardiovascular disease, cancer, diabetes, gastrointestinal problems, all of those sorts of longer term health effects that we often attribute to other causes, we now are much more aware are related to these sleep and circadian problems as well. SleepSync is an app that we have developed for shift workers in particular so that we can help them manage all of the associated issues with acquiring the required amount of sleep each night. And we've used this app to help individualize our intervention approach. Primarily, research and interventions in the past have been a kind of one-size-fits-all approach. And with using SleepSync, we've intended to make it a more individualized approach for each of the users. The app itself helps shift workers manage not only their work schedule, but also their personal obligations as well by putting everything into a calendar. The app then, based on their schedule of both work and personal obligations, provides the most biologically viable sleep recommendations for that individual that will allow them to sleep not only for the most amount of time possible, but also achieve the best sleep quality they can, particularly at times when they would be sleeping that you wouldn't normally be sleeping, so outside of that sort of nighttime sleep period. We implemented a study using SleepSync in shift workers who were primarily healthcare individuals, so nurses and emergency department personnel, but we also included a number of shift workers from other industries as well. So we had 27 people who trialed the app over a two-week period, and during that period we asked them to engage with the app as often as possible and to put in all their shift work schedule and their personal schedules as well, and then throughout the 2 weeks they received sleep recommendations for each night or day, as it may be, that they were working. We then measured both before the study and after the study a number of different factors, including their mental health. We also asked them to provide information on their sleep times, their sleep quality, and then we compared what we saw before and after. And in fact, we found that across the 2 weeks of using the app, their total sleep time increased on average by 29 minutes. We also found that there were significant improvements to their mental well-being with a reduction in the symptoms of depression and also a significant reduction in their anxiety as well. We also saw that they were able to fall asleep much better when they were using the app and faster. And we also saw that they had an improved sleep quality when they were sleeping as well. Although there's currently apps that exist that help advise on sleep, this one is particularly aimed at shift workers and is relates to how they have rapid changes between their sleep and wake times that their circadian clock finds it difficult to adjust to. And so rather than just applying what we know is a one-size-fits-all approach to managing sleep concerns, we really wanted to ensure that this particular cohort of people within our society were having it addressed adequately for their particular circumstances.